Hey guys, so today I'm going to be doing this look right here, and it is a chit chat get ready with me, and I talk about finishing up Invisalign and what's gonna happen. This is using the Dream Street palette, and I also talk about what I think of this palette. I really love this look like so much. I really hope you enjoy the video, and let's just get started. So I sent this to some of the people that I know, and I asked them, like, obviously light or dark, and most of them said dark, and then some of them said both, and then like one or two people said the light one. So I probably will end up doing both on my channel, but the first one I'm gonna do is the dark one because I really loved that look, and apparently a lot of other people did too. They said it made my eyes look really green. I was gonna do a completely matte teal smokey eye, but if you could see in the video, I do have some like shimmer. What I'm gonna do is use these two shades because that's what I did. Once again, I'm going to be using the Kathleen Lights Dream Street palette. I'm starting off with my Sante Super Smooth Concealer as usual. And then I'm going to set it with the cream shade just because the Kathleen Lights palette doesn't have a cream shade. I think what I figured out is I think I'm going to do the Chit Chat Get Ready With Me for my eyes, just so you can see pretty much everything I'm doing on my eyes. I'm gonna speed up my face. The first shades I'm gonna go in with are Shooting Star and Magical. First I'm gonna go in with Magical, the more orangey shade, and then Shooting Star. A while back, whenever I posted that Speed Get Ready With Me, there was something wrong and I talked about it in my vlog, but I didn't talk about what it was, and I was like, I'll do a Chit Chat Get Ready With Me. I'm not going to talk about what was wrong because I just want to keep that personal, but I am going to talk about, so as you can see, I don't have any attachments on anymore on my teeth, so I am done with Invisalign, but right now I still like have my regular trays in. So the past few videos I've actually been done with it, but I have to wear my last tray until my retainers come in. So right now, I'm actually wearing my bleaching trays, and I'm whitening my teeth as I do this. So I was like, well, I know this is going to take forever, so I might as well do that. And yeah, so now you can see my bare teeth. I haven't had bare teeth basically since I started my channel. I had like a couple videos at first where I didn't have Invisalign, and then I got it. So y'all have pretty much seen my teeth move. They weren't really that bad in the beginning, but now I'm gonna go in with Potion a little bit on the outer corner. And they said that basically they weren't too bad yet, but whenever I got older they would like all be crowded because they were already starting to crowd. So glad to have the attachments off my teeth. It's so weird because I've had them on for so long. I'm supposed to get my retainer pretty soon, but apparently we got bleaching trays with it, which I didn't know about. So that was kind of a perk, but they're like rubbery. Tell me if you can tell a difference in my teeth if you've been here from the beginning. And I'm gonna take Water Bearer and kind of put that in the crease really lightly. It's super pigmented, so yeah. So basically, after I get my retainers, I'm pretty much going to wear my retainers all the time for a while, and then I'm gonna be where I can wear them like just at night. I think it's gonna be so weird going from having trays in all the time to not having anything on my teeth, because my teeth feel so sharp because I haven't, you know, like had that. And if I have like a little bit of a lisp in this video, that's why, because these are so rubbery. This shade isn't like blending like so well, like it's kind of looks a little patchy like blending wise. What I did whenever I did that look, I took the NYX glitter primer, I just got this, and I put that down and it stuck so well, but at the same time it had like a line like right there where I didn't have it. So I don't know if I want to do this or not because I don't really want that line. I'm gonna still be on that Water Bearer shade but on an e.l.f. blending brush. I really want to do a video on my pet peeves, but I feel like it might be like, I don't know, offensive in some way. I don't really know, but yeah, so I really want to do it because, oh my goodness, I just get so annoyed and I can rant and rant and rant on my finger and just try and do it on the lid with nothing under it and we'll see how that works. And I'm trying not to put it up in the crease too much yet because I want to blend it up into the crease. See it like dragging? That's so weird. So now I'm gonna build it up with my finger once again. I feel like I might need to go in with it wet so that it doesn't like blend away. Whatever, I'm just done with this. Now I'm gonna go in with the NYX glitter primer. Blend it on the back of my hand first so that I'm not going in one big glob. And it gets super sticky, and then put it mostly on the inner corner and then just put it on the middle a little bit, but not too much because I don't want there to be that jacked up line. I'm gonna go in with Mermaid Boy, I think that's what it's called. I'm just trying to go straight in with it so it's sticky. And just look at that. I didn't use this with this part the first time I did it, but I'm glad I'm doing it because it looks like blue. Blend it and not have a harsh line there. Go up right at the top and blend it. And then I'm gonna take Mermaid Boy and just blend it into it. Okay, so I just feel like that this powder like is just so powdery. So I'm gonna try and spray my eye with this just to kinda try and get it to not be powdery. And now I'm gonna do the other eye. I kept redoing this part of the eye to try and get these as even as possible, and I think that's about as good as they're gonna get. I just set both of them with that Mod Rescue spray, and I feel like they still transfer, but like, I don't know, I just feel like they're a lot more like intact. I didn't really talk about the palette, like how I like it, so I'll do that after my base is done. I'll do it like while I'm doing like bronzer and stuff. I think this eye is just a different shape and that's why I couldn't get it, but my eye's like burning from how many times I build it up and removed it and build it up and removed. I'm going to do my face now. My camera cut off. I know I showed what I was using, but I thought I'd just talk about it. So I used the Smashbox Pore Minimizing Primer with the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. And I've never used these two before. I don't know why. I guess because the Wet n Wild one was already so flawless on its own. But then on top, baking it with this, the Fit Me powder, that makes it even more flawless. My base is like the most flawless it's ever been. But for concealer, I kind of corrected with the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Eraser Dark Circle and Brightening just a little Bit here. I used a little bit of my Tarte Shape Tape, and you saw that I was kind of doing this, but that's because I was like kind of letting it set a little bit so I'd have a little more coverage. And I feel like this is the most flawless base I've ever had. Now, moving on to the face, I'm going to talk about the Dream Street palette a little bit while I'm doing my face for my bronzer, and it's the e.l.f. Light Matte Bronzer. I'm gonna tap it in and tap off a bunch because I don't want to get like streaks, because sometimes that will happen. What I think of the palette. So I love how there's wearable shades and pops of color in there. I just really love that. Because I feel like that's a perfect travel palette, because I can do like warm brown looks, I can do super like wearable just like one color in the crease, I can do like a two color, like one shimmer on the lid and one in the crease. I can do a big smoky eye like this. Like, I would never do that out in public, but you know. And so, and I like how there's an orange in there as well, because you can just do whatever with that palette basically. But the orange isn't as pigmented as the orange Slim Fit, I think that's what it's called, in my custom ColourPop palette. That is a lot more intense. They're pretty much almost the same color. Kathleen's just a lot more natural. And I mean, I guess that's good, but yeah. So if you want a like orange smoky eye like I've done in the past with Slim Fit, you might not get that look. I filled in my eyebrows with the LA Colors, same my eyeshadow, the dark one. I really like it for my brows. I think it's not too warm or cool. I just love the color scheme in this palette. Like, I love how you have these like complementary teal shades, and then you can use these together, and then like you can make so many different looks with it, and then you can make natural. I love that. Now I'm gonna go in with Tarte Amazonian Clay Blush and Party. I don't know where these brushes are from. I mean, they literally look like kind of little kid brushes, but they are so good. I got them for Christmas, but it only came in a 4-piece set, and there wasn't a name or anything. But they're so soft. I can't use it under my eyes though, because it is that kind where it like pokes, and it's kind of poking my face right now. But for highlighter, I'm gonna use my Smashbox Spotlight Pearl Highlighting Palette, but I'm just gonna use this shade because the last time I tried to mix it with the second shade, it was awful. Like, oh my goodness, it's so sad that I can only use that shade. Maybe one day if I ever get tan, which will never happen, I'll be able to use that, but I'm not impressed. I talked about it in my, I don't know, it was so long ago. I was rewatching videos the other day of me, but like my old videos, and I didn't realize how long ago I got this. I got this in like June, and yeah, I was saying how I wasn't too impressed with it back then either. I think I'm gonna do my skincare routine, because I think I've gotten it down. I've been doing the same thing for about a couple weeks now, and I've actually been doing morning and night stuff pretty much every day, which I used to never be that good about it, like actually do it morning and night. I think I've gotten it down to something that works for me, and I think I'm gonna do a skincare routine. I'm gonna take that same shade and highlight the brow. I'm gonna go to the lower lash line. I'm gonna spray my face once again. First, I'm gonna go in with the two transition shades once again. I'll go in with Shooting Star first, and I'm gonna use my e.l.f. Detail Crease Brush. I'm gonna go in lightly with Water Bearer on the same brush, and then I'm going to go in with Water Bearer on a dense brush, and I'm gonna take just a little bit of the NYX glitter primer and do it like on the very inner corner, and then on the inner part of the lower lash line. I'm gonna go in with Kaleidoscope on the very inner corner. Just so that now when I go in with Mermaid Boy, it'll kind of blend in. And then go in with Kaleidoscope again, just to kind of blend it. This is a lot different than my last teal smoky. I like this so much better. I don't really like how that one turned out. Now I'm gonna go put on my Airway Studio Alexis lashes. This is the eye look. I love it so much. Like, this is probably my favorite green look I've ever done. Blue, green, teal, whatever you want to call it. So the last thing I'm going to do is take my Maybelline Master Precise Skinny and go on my upper lash line. I like doing this after I put on my eyelashes just because I feel like it kind of like pushes them up a little more. I'm also going to put this on my waterline as well. I'm going to go over that with the matte teal. Now, this is the finished eye look. Now for the lips, I'm going to go in with the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in London, just because I wanted something pretty cool tone, but with not like a gray, which right now this looks pretty warm, but you will see. Really want to use the gloss, so that's what I'm going to be doing. And that's what makes this more nude and a little more cool tint. Whenever it's over a lipstick, you can't really tell there's too much glitter in it. I can't just wear this on its own. I feel like I need a pretty intense smoky eye to be able to wear this. This is the finished look. So glad I finally got to film this. Like, I've been wanting to film it so bad since I played with this on the eyes. Once again, tell me down below if you want to see that other look, that orangey light one. I'm so obsessed with this makeup. Tell me if you want to see any more looks with the Dream Street palette. I know this is my second one, but it's fine. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Please, please, please leave any video recommendations, any tour recommendations, any sit-down video recommendations, any challenges. I really want to do like some challenges on my channel, but I don't know what y'all want to see. So just tell me down below. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!